So today we will learn about the three-phase circuit. Okay, in AC circuit there are two types of circuit configuration as per the waveform. Okay, one is single phase, another one is three-phase. Okay, now here we are discussing about the three-phase circuit. Okay, just a minute. So in this session, you will learn about this three-phase system first, okay? The type of three-phase system. Next, the star connection and relationship between the current and voltage. That means there are two types of three-phase system. One is star, okay? Another one is delta. Okay, so first one is the star connection and relationship between currents and voltages. Second one is the delta connection and its relationship between current and voltage. Next, what is the advantage of three-phase over the single-phase system? So this one is very important because from this discussion, you will learn that why this three-phase use of three-phase is much more advantageous than single-phase system. Okay.
Sir, some students are waiting.
No, there is no one. If there is someone is waiting, I will let them enter. Up to 3:15. Don't interrupt during the study, okay? Now, next one is the numerical and some assignments, okay? Now, first is the three-phase system. From the previous, you learned one only alternating waveform is present. Okay, only one waveform is present. This is the first waveform. Okay, now if after some time another waveform starts, if after some time another waveform, suppose from here, another waveform, suppose, starts. Okay? So, here you will see two waveforms. Okay? In normal AC circuit, in normal single phase network, this kind of waveform looks like one is positive. Okay? Another one is for the return path. Okay. Okay. So let me erase this second curve. Okay. Now, in case of single phase circuit, this kind of waveform. Ankita Anand, why did you give your attendance now? Did I tell you to give attendance right now? Ankita Anand, are you present? Reply. Ankita Anand, are you present? Okay, who is the CR appointed for this batch F? Is there any CR till now?
No one is appointed.
Okay, fine. Then I have to directly report that to your coordinator. Fine. Okay. So, this is the single phase system. Okay. One phase is just supplying this type of waveform. Right? In three-phase system, what is the advantage? In three-phase system, one second waveform started after the 120 degree of the first waveform. Okay, is that clear? One second waveform just started after the 120 degree of the second waveform. 120 degree of the first waveform. This is the first waveform. Okay, after 120 degree, this is your 90 degree, right? Now, this one is your 120 degree. So, after 120 degree conduction of the first waveform, another waveform starts. Okay? So, that is the second waveform. Right? And after 120 degree conduction of second waveform, another waveform starts. So that is the third waveform. So like this, three-phase system is developed. Okay, here you can see the green one is the phase one, the red one is the phase two, and the blue one is the phase three. And as you can see, the phase one, this is your peak point of the phase one, okay? And all the waveforms has the same peak point. Look here, okay? That is the 180 degree, okay? This one is the 180 degree, and it starts after the 120 degree conduction of the first phase. Here you can see this is the 120 degree, okay? At 120 degree, this second waveform actually start. And after 120 degree of the second waveform, so at this point, the third waveform started, right? So this third waveform is lagging with respect to first waveform by how much degree? Can you answer? Can anyone answer? Can anyone answer? See, this second phase, look, the phase two, okay? Try to understand. Phase one is your reference, right? Phase one is your reference, and phase two started after the 120 degree, in 120 degree lagging condition, right? 120 degree lag with respect to which one? Tell me. With respect to phase one. Okay? With respect to phase one. Now, if I want to describe the phase 3, what I can write? It is at 120 degree lagging. It is 120 degree lagging with respect to which one? Phase 2. Okay? With respect to phase 2. So ultimately, this phase 3 is lagging how much degree with respect to phase 1?
240
degree, exactly. So from this configuration, I can say that the phase 3 is here, I am writing, it is 240 degree lagging by phase 1. Okay. So from here, you can easily develop their waveform equations. Okay. Now, what will be their equation? Their equation, suppose, okay, the phase one waveform is the reference waveform, right? So, can you tell me what may be the equation of the phase one if this is one voltage waveform, suppose? Can anyone tell me? For phase one, what I can write?
A cos omega t plus phi.
Right. So, for that one, okay, let me erase this one first. Okay. So, first we are going to write the phase one equation, okay? So V1 I am writing, right? Equals to V max, right? Because this one is the peak value into sine. This is one sinusoidal waveform, that is sine omega t plus phi. Now here, for reference waveform, is there any phi? Is there any phase difference? No, because that starts from 0, 0, from the origin. So here phi value is 0, correct? Now for the phase 2, for the phase 2, what I can write, that is also V max, because the peak values are same. Look, the peak values are same, correct? So I am writing here again the V max, correct? Now, what should I write? Sine, tell me, what should I write here? Sine omega t minus 120 degree, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Because if this one is 120 degree lagging with respect to phase 1. Correct? Now, third one, what I can write? V max, because whatever we want to describe, whatever waveform you want to describe, that should be with respect to the reference. Okay, so V3 equals to V max. What should I write? Please tell me.
Sine
minus 240. Exactly. Sine omega t minus 240 degree. Right? So this is the basic concept of construction of three-phase waveform. Okay. All the phases are 120 degree lagging with respect to the previous. Okay, phase 2 is lagging by 120 degree. Phase 3 is lagging 120 degree with respect to phase 2. So total 240 degree lagging. Right. Now, here, why this one is required? Why instead of single phase system, three phase system is required? Just try to understand by this waveform. Okay. In this waveform, if you want to develop the power will look like this, also alternating in nature, but it will be a little bit amplified because V into I, isn't it? Okay, so V, I, for this single phase system, V and I, both are alternating in nature and their power is also, see, it is varying. So if you want to harness this kind of power, you will see that your mobile is charging for 1 second. And also here, it is discharging for the second condition. Okay, because see here, power is negative. Okay, or if any alternating instrument you are using, then you will see that due to this alternating nature of the power, you are not getting constant energy. Okay. So in three phase case, this one is just removed. Their voltage level becomes constant like this. See, in the three phase system, the voltage level looks like always this. Okay, it is almost constant. Okay, if you draw the mean path, okay, if you draw the mean path, you will see one constant voltage level you are getting. But here in single phase case, you are not getting a particular constant voltage. It is alternating. But here, when three phase system you are using, at that time, due to this type of construction, you are getting constant voltage level. Although all the waveforms are alternating in nature, but their mean value is finite and constant. Okay, so that's why the three-phase system is little bit advantageous, or you can say it is more advantageous than the single-phase system. Okay, Is that clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we are going to discuss the types of connection. Okay, so total two types of connection is possible. So basic two types of connections are star connection and delta connection. Okay, so what is the beauty of this star connection? That the beauty is, in star connection, all the paths are meeting at point. Okay, all the three phases are meeting at particular node. Okay, this node is called the neutral point. Okay, all the, suppose this is your first phase. Okay, this is your first phase, right? This one is, suppose, your second phase. This one is your first phase. This one is your second phase. Okay, and this one is your, suppose, third phase. Okay, and if all the currents or all the here, all the currents, if you take, then at this node, you will see that the current value is also zero. At node, current value is zero. If you apply the KCL, simple KCL, okay, you will see the current value at this node is zero. So in three-phase system, this node is called the neutral point. Okay, now how here we can calculate the voltage and current and power. So if you want to understand that, you have to learn two types of voltage system. One is phase voltage, another one is line voltage. Two types of voltage concept is here. They are obviously related with each other, but how? Why this one is important? See, when we are talking about only simple one waveform, then one voltage is present. Okay, this voltage is called basically the phase voltage. Okay, so in three-phase system, this type of voltage we can measure from this point to the neutral. If you measure, if you put the multimeter, okay, suppose you set the multimeter into voltage point and you are putting one lead to the neutral point and another lead to one phase, right? So whatever reading you are observing, that reading is called the phase voltage. Okay, here two voltage concept is here. They are obviously related. I am coming into that. Okay, so first one is the phase voltage. How you can measure? You can measure by this type. Okay, one lead is connected at one phase and another lead of the multimeter is connected into that neutral point. So whatever voltage value you are observing, that is called the phase voltage. Okay, similarly, if you connect the lead here, okay, here also you will see phase voltage. But remember, multimeter cannot give you the value of the angle. They only give you the magnitudes, right? So here, phase voltage, whatever you are getting, suppose phase voltage is V. So here also phase voltage you will get as V because they are same. But what is their difference? Their difference is in angles. They are either leading or lagging. Okay, but multimeter cannot show you that angle. Okay, now similarly, if you want to calculate the voltage between this and the neutral point, also you will get the same phase voltage. Okay, phase voltage concept is clear, I think. Yes or no? Is that best? Okay, fine. So now we will discuss the line voltage. What is line voltage? Line voltage is, suppose, one lead of the multimeter. This is your multimeter, okay? One lead is connected here, okay? And another lead, instead of the neutral point, you connected at another phase, okay? So, whatever voltage you are observing here in the digital system, that voltage is called the line voltage. That means in between two phase, whatever voltage is present, that is called the line voltage. Okay? So, also, suppose here the line voltage is V1 or VL. Okay? The phase voltage here, I am writing V phase. It will help you to understand. Okay, here this one is V phase, right? Now here I connected the leads at L1 and here this port is called the L3 port, okay? So whatever voltage you are observing in that multimeter, that is the line voltage. Similarly, if you connect the two leads between this first phase and second phase, okay? You will get the same magnitude, that is the line voltage. Okay? So now, what is line voltage? What is phase voltage? Is that clear? Yes or no? Do I need to repeat?
Sir, line voltage is clear, but the phase voltage is not totally clear.
Okay, okay. So, okay, fine. See, here, this is the star system, okay? This is the star system. This one is the neutral point, okay? If you measure the voltage between one phase and the neutral, this voltage, okay, this is called the phase voltage. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Between one phase and the neutral point, if you measure the voltage using the multimeter, that value is called the phase voltage. Okay? And if you measure the voltage between two phases, this phase and this phase, then it is called the line voltage.
Line voltage, yes, sir.
Okay?
Yes.
Now, okay, fine. So, this star connection is written here, okay? The theoretical part, whatever I discussed, that is written here, okay? Now, this neutral from the neutral, one wire is always connected to the earth, okay? Why? Because if any unbalanced situation is developed, suppose there is one short circuit. Okay. Suppose these two phases, this phase and this phase, accidentally gets shorted. Okay. Then there will be one huge amount of unbalanced current. So, if this neutral point is connected to earth, automatically the unbalanced, all huge amount of current will flow to the earth, okay, and it will save your appliances, it will save your induction oven, or it will save your refrigerator. If there is any short circuit accidentally, you will not do it intentionally, okay. If you did accidentally any short circuit condition, you developed any accidentally short circuit condition, then that higher amount of unbalanced current will flow through the neutral and it will ground. So that's why the star connection construction is very important, because we have one safety point in that star connection. What is that point? That is neutral point. Okay, so that is written here. Look, the star connection requires four wires, okay, three were for three phases, okay, and one is for neutral conductor, right? And the star connected three phase system gives two different voltages, 230 volt and 440 volt. The voltage between the single phase and neutral is 230 volt, and voltage between two phase is equal to the 440 volt. Now, it may come into your mind that, why, sir, you are saying that this is 440 volt and this is 230 volt. Why? How will you get that magnitude? You will get that magnitude using one simple relation. Okay, there is one relation between phase voltage and line voltage, so that you can simultaneously calculate the phase voltage and line voltage. Okay, if you know the line voltage, you can calculate the phase voltage and vice versa case. Okay, so the rule is this. Okay, line voltage is equal to root 3 into phase voltage, and line current is equal to the phase current. Okay, you have to remember this. This point is very important. Okay, line voltage equals to root 3 into phase voltage. Now, also you can develop this equation. It is not arbitrarily developed. Okay, without any proof, we cannot say this one. This one is with proof. Okay, now look here, and one simple thing, if you can remember, it will help you. Okay, I will tell you later, just stay here, I will tell you. Okay, one by one. Now this one is, I think this all of you remember this equation, that is E line equals to root 3 into E phase. Okay, and I line equals to I phase. So whatever line current is there, phase current is also same. Why? Because remember the construction, this is your star construction, right? In that star construction, this whatever current, suppose here one current is flowing, okay, this is I1. Suppose I am writing here I phase 1. Okay. Now, I phase 1 here is flowing through the one phase. Okay. And this is also the current that is flowing through this line also. Yes or no? Because this current is flowing in this direction. Okay, this is also flowing through one phase, and since one line is present here, so it is also the line current. So here in star connection, we can say that line current and phase current both are same, right? Because here, whatever line concept is present, the phase concept is also same for the current. But in case of voltage, these two are little bit different, right? Because if we talk about the voltage, then what is the phase voltage? Phase voltage is, suppose E phase or V phase. E phase is the phase voltage between one phase to the neutral point, right? This is the neutral point. But what is the line voltage? Line voltage is the voltage between two phase. Okay, this is called the E line. Okay, so there is the difference in concept of line and phase, right, in case of voltage and current. Now, before describing the relation between the phase voltage, just first look the star volt, the delta connection. Okay, now this one is the delta connection. This will look like this. Okay, now here in delta connection, you will see that phase voltage, what is your phase voltage? What is our concept? The phase voltage is there you cannot decide which one is phase, which one is the line, you can say. But in delta connection, you cannot describe the phase because here, look, there is no neutral point. Okay? In three-phase delta connection, there is no neutral point. So this one is little bit disadvantageous in case of safety. Right? So here, what is our concept of line? Here, line is present, okay, but phase is not present. So here we can say that line voltage, here line voltage equals to the phase voltage, just opposite of the star connection, right? And in case of current, here, if this one is the line current, the phase current will be root 3 times diminished. Okay? That means I line equals to root 3 into I phase. Sorry. And the line voltage is equals to the phase voltage. Okay? This is the delta connection. And this one is the star connection. Okay? Don't get confused. In case of star connection, it is advantageous because we have the neutral point. So that's why the calculation is easy. Okay? Here, there is no neutral point. Okay? So here, the line and phase only will be different in case of the current, not in case of voltage. Okay? Now, because whatever voltage is here, this is your phase and this is also your line. Okay? So here the voltage, the phase voltage is same with the line voltage. And the line current is equals to the root 3 times of the phase current. Okay? So, I am just writing for both case. Okay? Remember this one. First, for the star connection. Okay? For star connection, what is present? The line current IL equals to the phase current. Okay? For delta case, for delta case, this I line equals to the root 3 times of the I phase. Okay? And for star connection, the voltage relation is VL equals to root 3 into V phase. Okay, and for delta connection, VL equals to V phase. Okay, so this small equations you have to remember. Okay, now the short description how these equations are developed. Okay, so first, this three-phase system is described by the words R, Y, and B. Okay. In the wire bundle, you may have seen three types of wire, or rather you can say four types of wire. Okay. One is the red wire. Okay. Another one is the yellow wire. Okay. Another one is the blue wire. Okay. And either black or green wire is used. Where? In neutral case, neutral wire, black or green type wire is used to describe the neutral conductor. Okay, now the red conductor describes the R phase, or you can say the phase one. YOLO conductor represents the YOLO phase, or you can say the phase two. And blue conductor represents the third phase, that is blue, that is represents by this word B. And the neutral wire is represented by this kind of conductors, either black or green. Okay, so from the first words, the phases were named R, Y, B. Okay, if you say R, Y, B phase, then that will represent the three phase system. Okay, so is that clear till now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So now let me erase this one because I don't have much space here. Okay. Okay. Just a minute. Now, here you are observing two types of voltage. One is the phase voltage that is named as E phase here. Okay, I hope you can say this. And between the R, Y, and B. Okay, suppose this is your R phase. Okay, how is your Y phase? That will be 120 degree lagging. And this one is your B. Correct? So R, Y, B, or R, B, Y, whatever you can say. Correct. Now, this ENR, that means neutral to red, that is nothing but your phase voltage, correct? So here, this is your R, that is your phase voltage. So without writing the ENR, you can write here as ER, okay? Now, similarly, instead of writing this ENY, that means neutral to YOLO, you can write here EY, that will represent the phase voltage of YOLO. Okay, and this ENB can represent the EB. Clear till now? Okay, and you can see the 120 degree phase displacement here, this one, is it okay? This is your 120 degree phase displacement. Okay. This is your EY. This one is your EB. And look, their magnitudes are same. Only what is your different? The difference is in the angle. Okay. So that is written here. ENR equals to ENY equals to ENB equals to E phase. Right? Now, from this point, what is the resultant vector if you want to calculate between the R and Y? Okay, how will you calculate the resultant vector between the R and Y? So resultant vector ERY you can develop by ENY minus ENR, that is the vector equation. I hope you can understand this one. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what is your ENY? Here, this one is your ENY. Or you can say EY. Right? That is the phase voltage. Neutral to YOLO. And from neutral to YOLO, whatever voltage you can measure, that is the phase voltage. Okay? Minus ENR. So ENR minus, that means this NR point must be extended to the minus sign here. Okay. So, and then this is your ENR. This side, if you want to draw, that will give you the ENR with, ENR. this one will be, what is minus ENR? That means you have to extend the phase voltage at R phase into negative side. Okay, so now you need to calculate the vector. Okay, so here use the vector calculation. So ERY you can get easily. Is this clear?
Yes,
now calculate the magnitude.
Sir.
Okay, now calculate the magnitude on your own. Okay, how will you calculate? What is the ERY? ERY. That is nothing but the voltage between two phase, that is R phase and YOLO phase. So that means this is nothing but the line voltage, isn't it? This one is basically the line voltage. Because this is the voltage between two phase, look, R phase and Y phase. So this is nothing but the line voltage, right? And ENR, this is nothing but the phase voltage. ENR, ENY, ENV, these are basically called the phase voltages, right? So how will you calculate? Root under of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta, under root. That is the equation of resultant vector, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So I am writing that same 11-12 concept. Okay, what is the EL? That is the, see here, what is ERY? ERY, here two vectors are present. One is ENR, another one is ENY. Okay, so I am writing here ENR square plus ENY square plus 2AB cos theta, right? What is the theta value? Here, look, theta value is your, how much? This is your theta, 60 degree, exactly. So this is your 2AB cos 60, okay? Now, if you, what is ENR? ENR is nothing but your phase voltage, right? What is your ENY? That is also your phase voltage. So from here, you will get that the total line voltage EL or ERY is root under 3 of your E phase. Okay, that is also done here. Look. Okay. Is that clear? This calculation?
Yes, sir.
So similarly, other phase voltages, other from other phase relations, you can calculate the line voltages also. Clear? Fine. So this is basically how the relation is developed. Okay, don't just mechanically understand, mechanically remember, always question that why this is developed, how this is developed. That's when you can understand. Okay, and you can remember this one also. Okay, don't just blindly follow anything. Okay, so with this, I am concluding today's class. From next class, we will discuss the delta connection, right? And if you can develop like this formation, you can do at home, or in next class, I will explain, okay? How that relation, this delta relation, this one, how it is developed, I will discuss that. Okay, so all of you give your attendance right now. I am concluding today's class. Okay, yes, tell me.
Sir, aapne abhi bataya star connection mein neutral point ko hum earth kar denge. To kisi bhi unfavorable condition mein wo sara current jo hai wo earthing mein chala jayega.
Exactly.
Is circuit ko kaise pata chalega ki ye condition unfavorable hai? Wo to continuously earthing mein current transfer karta rahega.
नहीं, जब कोई normal, suppose this is your R, okay, in three phase, in all phases currents are flowing in outside direction, outward direction, right? Here IR, here IY, here IB, सारे करंट तो बाहर जा रहा है ना टुवर्ड्स लोड, ना? तो यहाँ पे हम जब ये रिलेशन जब ड्रॉ कर कैलकुलेट करेंगे आई आर प्लस आई वाई प्लस आई बी, तो अकॉर्डिंग टू द KCL, what I can say at node, this is zero, nothing but zero. That is the, that's why the neutral point concept is coming. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now suppose there is any unbalanced current. Okay. Suppose these two phases are being short circuited. These two phases were short circuited. They are connected by a short wire. Okay. Then what will happen? Then what will happen without transferring the current towards the load, the maximum amount of current will flow in this loop, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Maximum current will flow from BY, BY, BY again. So what will happen if this kind of unbalanced situation will occur, then what will happen? Look here, IY and IB, this will be more. Yes. So that extra amount of current will flow through that neutral path, because at that time this value won't be zero. But according to KCL, at any node the current must be zero at any node. Okay, so if that zero value is increased due to any short circuit or any kind of fault, okay, suppose in IY connection there is one fault, in phase fault. Okay, so at that time, through that IY, more current will flow, right? So at that time, IR and IY, IR and IB will be less. Okay, so at that time, here we will install the circuit breaker to save our appliances. Only neutral cannot handle everything. That's why now, at home you are using fuse. Why you are using fuse instead you are in your home, you will see one ground where one earthing is also done, that is using, that is as you are working as your neutral. But why still you are using the fuse? Because only neutral, only the grounding cannot handle all the unbalanced conditions. Okay, it can simply eliminate the any improper, or you can say the unbalanced flow till a certain amount. Okay?
Yes. Clear?
Okay, fine. So thank you everyone.
Thank you,
all
sir.
Of you gave your attention.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you everyone. So those who have given your attendances, you may leave the meeting. Your class is already over. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.